Hi, this is Alex from MinuteEarth. Each spring in California, so many almond trees put out flowers at the same time that local bees can't pollinate them all. So almond farmers pay beekeepers to bring bees from all over the country at exactly the moment the trees flower. That might seem crazy, but almonds and other bee-pollinated crops are worth $17 billion a year, so it's worth it to farmers and to beekeepers who make more money renting out their bees than selling honey. Unfortunately, when we bring so many bees together, parasites and diseases easily spread from one bee colony to another. And when bees feed on just one type of crop at a time, they don't get all the vitamins and minerals they need. What's more, the honeybees can get sickened by the pesticides that keep crops safe from other insects. As a result of all this, since 1960, the number of commercial bees in the US has fallen by half. And since so many crops require bees for pollination, and farmers are planting more crops every year to keep up with demand, if bee numbers continue to drop, it could jeopardize our future food supply. But we're learning how to help bees. Beekeepers and farmers are working together to reduce bees' exposure to pesticides. Nonprofits and bee lovers are planting more wildflowers across the landscape, so commercial and wild bees have a more diverse diet. And universities are breeding parasite and disease-resistant bees. And we can also help bees fight parasites with a chemical weapon they already have in their own arsenal, propolis. Honeybees in the wild smear this substance inside their nests, which sanitizes them and keeps intruders out. To make propolis, bees visit trees and collect resins rich in flavonoids and aromatic acids, which are toxic to many organisms. Then they mix the resins with wax, making a sticky, antibiotic glue. Bees in commercial hives also make propolis, but they use it only to seal gaps and don't smear it on the inside walls, probably because the walls are smoother than the inside of a tree. In these hives, bee larvae often get sick. But if you build a hive out of rough, unfinished lumber, or attach plastic pieces filled with holes to the walls, bees spread way more propolis, and their larvae suffer way fewer infections. So beekeepers are starting to rough up their own beehives to encourage their bees to spread propolis. This helps the bees stay healthy and keeps them pollinating crops and making honey. That is a sweet solution. This video was sponsored by the University of Minnesota, where students, faculty, and staff across all fields of study are working to solve the grand challenges facing society. One of these challenges is to ensure we can feed the world sustainably, and part of the solution is to foster ecosystem resilience. In the Department of Entomology, Professor Marla Spivak and researchers in the Bee Lab are working to promote the conservation, health, and diversity of the bees that pollinate our crops, whether they're wild or commercial. The Bee Lab has even bred a line of disease-resistant honeybees. Thanks, University of Minnesota.